So it's 8:30 now. We'll start with the second lecture of social studies. As we all know that in the previous chapter, we started with the first chapter of history, and that was new empires and kingdoms. So today we are going to continue with the second period. So in the first chapter, we studied the rise and fall of the different kingdoms from north and south. As you have already studied, because the material was given you all in the prior, so you all know that what's the second period? It's about administration of a kingdom. So I'm going to present my screen now so that you all can see the PPT. Okay, so let's begin with the class. I hope you all are ready. So the second period of history, new empires and kingdoms. Today we are going to study the administration of the kingdoms. So in that, we are going to see how the kingdom was administered in that time. You have seen a pattern in every major kingdom that was established in India. They are talking about the pattern which we have studied, like how the king established their kingdom, how they built a kingdom and into a big empire. So what is the pattern? That was the first question of the worksheet. So it is a strong person established the kingdom and then his successors expanded it. Successors are the people, you can say, as generation. It might be his son, it might be his chief commander-in-chief, or the people who are working under that king, or the, you can say, the trustworthy person of that king to whom that king is handover in his kingdom or the empire. So we all know that how a kingdom runs. If a king dies, then his son is ready to take the throne. So similarly, a strong person established the kingdom and then his successors expanded it. How did they expand? Now we all know that to run any kind of kingdom or an empire, we need a lot of things to be planned. So how did they expand? By conquering neighboring kingdoms. Conquering neighboring kingdoms means they fought the battle, they had a war. If they want to rule or they want that territory or they want that kingdom, they have to conquer it. What did they need for this conquest? An army. We all know that a king had his army so that he can fight a war and he can conquer the neighboring kingdoms. What do you need to manage and maintain an army? We need money. Where does this money come from? It comes from the taxes. And who pay the taxes? These taxes are paid by the ordinary people living in that kingdom. As you all know now, that we do also pay kingdom to the as we also pay taxes to the government. So they provide us with they provide us a lot of services in return of money which we pay to them in the form of tax. Could a good king just make people pay tax without giving anything in return? So it is similar. It is give and take. Until and unless you don't give good services, people are not going to give you tax, or people are not going to respond to you. So it's obvious a no. The king also has to provide other services to the people like roads, dams, schools, temples, hospitals, etc. All this is administration of the kingdom. To do this, the king needed a lot of officers at different levels. All these people together help the king with administration of the kingdom. Administration of the kingdom was a very big task which needed a lot of people to do a lot of things. So there were a lot of committees at different levels. There were groups for different activities too. Now we all know that a single person cannot have a hold of all these things. He need different people to look after different activities carried in the kingdom or an empire. Some officers were appointed based on their own merit, which means if they were good at certain task. So, if a person is good in handling all the money issues, which we called it as an accountant, so that person was appointed as an accountant in his kingdom. So, according to or you're based on your talent, the person was appointed to be that officer. Some positions were hereditary, which means that person's job would be passed on to his son. So, what do you mean by hereditary? Hereditary is that your job or your talent is passed from your father to the son. So, we are discussing that how the positions of the officer were decided. So, it was like, first of all, it was based on the merit. That means the person who is good at some work was appointed to do that work. Second was hereditary. Hereditary means it was passed on from his father to his son. And other type of selection of officer was, or the position were decided from the people who were wealthy apart from the king. Like there are apart from king, there are people in the kingdom who hold a wealthy position in the life. So these people were also considered to be one of the officers in the administration. Some positions were given to people who were popular in an area that can be in a good way or a bad way. Okay, so we just need to consider in a good way. That would be better. Okay. Sometimes one person was given more than one position too. So if I am an accountant and I am good at some other work also, so apart from being an accountant, I was appointed for other work also in the administration. All this seems okay, but then once in a while, one of these officers could be very smart and become more powerful. And then he could overpower and overthrow the king. When this happens is if that person or the officer is very smart enough, and if he thinks that I am more powerful and I can handle the king easily, or I am more capable than the king, then he tries to overpower and overthrow the king. It happens when the king is very weak or he is not able to manage the kingdom properly. At that time, this happens, and the other officer who held the more powerful position in the administration or in the kingdom can overthrow him. Moving towards the next part, students, if you are typing, so you can just let it be and pay attention to the next slide. Now, having an army is first a big task, but the other main task is how to manage the army. Now you know that the army was a very important part of the kingdom. Kings tried to maintain very strong and well-trained armies. Armies needed elephants, chariots, soldiers on horses, foot soldiers, weapons, and so many more things. Some of the soldiers were given salaries and weapons by the king. Some of the soldiers were independent. That means they had their own horses and weapons. So in the army, there were two types of soldiers. So the soldiers where the weapons and salaries were provided by the king. And there were some strong soldiers, you can say, which were independent and had their own horses and weapons. This might happen because that person was willing to serve himself for the kingdom, and he did all his ways to be a good soldier and independent one. So, how do you think that worked? The independent soldiers were paid by a different leader. Apart from his own interest, there was a different leader who provided or who paid these independent soldiers. The king did not give money to that leader, instead, gave that leader some land from the kingdom. The leader had to make his own money by using that land. Now, The king was not looking into this soldier. Instead, what he did is he appointed a person who can look into this independent soldiers, and he instead of giving or providing money to that person, what he did that he gave a part of land. You know that kings are wealthy and they have a lot of land and money and treasure. So instead of giving money, he gave that person a part of land and asked him to look after this independent soldier. And what was the job of this leader? The job of this leader was to pay this independent soldiers, and how to pay? What he can do using that land. So he can do farming from that, or however he can do, he can use that land anyhow he wants, but he just need to pay to the independent soldier once that land was given by the king to him. So how did that leader make money? By collecting land revenue from the people. Now that part of land, obviously it was not barren. There were people living in it. There were people, the people were working on it. Farming was done. So we all know that at that time, how did they collect taxes? They had various ways to collect the taxes. So land revenue is part of it. Like on the land, on the part of land which you are living, you need to pay that, because we are providing that, providing you that land. So you need to pay in return, right? So it was like give and take. So how did this leader make money? By collecting land revenue from the people. Wait a minute. Wasn't this the role of the king? We all know that this role, collecting taxes, was the role of king, right? In the beginning, we read it. Yes, this was, so this leader kind of became the ruler of the land. So now you got it, that whoever collects the tax becomes a powerful person and ultimately becomes a ruler. Why do you think the king might have done such a thing? Now that's a risky thing, right? Giving a part of your land, and you might have that thought that if this person overthrow me and become the next king, but he did that. So why do you think he might have done such a thing? It may be because the king didn't always have enough money in his treasury. This might happen. We have that concept that kings are very wealthy, they are very rich, and they have a lot of money and land with them. But it is not always true. King also runs out of money from his treasury. Why this happens? Because of many, first of all, basically there are many natural regions, you can say natural calamities. If a part or if a kingdom face drought condition, when there is no rain throughout the year, so the king has to find food for his people, right? If it is a, if he is a good king, he need to give all best services to his people so that his people may keep their trust on this king. So because of many other reasons, there might be flood, there might be a war, because of which he might run out of money and he has no enough money in the treasury. So for this condition, and if war is happening, so he need to keep a backup, right? So that a good army can fight the other king and overthrow him and keep his kingdom or empire safe. So he need to keep many of the backup plans. So this was one of his backup plans. Being having a fear of being overthrown by that officer, he need to take this decision. Not having an army was not okay. So it was better to at least have a proper army this way, as I explained you. So this arrangement does seem okay at first, as I said, that every decision has its advantages and disadvantages. In the beginning, when everything is fine, it seems to be okay. But again, some leaders would become really strong this way. See, students, what happens is when you start getting more importance, when you start feeling more powerful. Now, boys know this kind of thing. In superhero movies, it happens most of the time that villain gets more powerful and he tries to rule the entire world, right? So similarly, it happens in this case also. Some leaders, where they start feeling that they are really strong, what they do is, And if the king happened to be weak, these leaders would start establishing independent kingdoms.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.